Hello people, I'm Ginny Metheral and I am a fourth generation witch. Today's video is all about protection spell jars, and there are two types of protection spell jars that I'm going to show you. There is the back off, little sting in the tail protection spell jar, and then there is the keep you safe and nurtured. So here is my protection spells. Why would you use a protection spell jar? Why would you put a spell into a jar? Well, essentially it's for a portable charm. It's so that you can carry it around, say in your handbag, you could put it in the car, you could put it under your friend's mattress. Although being your spell, it probably won't work that well with their energy, because spells have to be performed really by the person who wants them done. That's why when I'm doing my client sections, my clients are always like, well, can't you do the spell? And I'm like, no, you're going to do the spell. I'm going to help you and check that the spell is set. So why would you have protection in a spell jar? Well, this is particularly good, especially for me, as I am not the world's greatest driver. And so I actually have this spell jar in my car, along with a couple of other things, just to help me along the road. I start looking at the countryside, admiring the prettiness of the villages that I'm driving through, and pay no attention to what's in front of me whatsoever. Luckily, I'm not a fast driver, is all I can say, and I do try. So I have a couple of spell jars that I keep in my car just to help me keep my concentration and drive safely. I also like using a spell jar because the spell is enclosed within the jar, and that means that it can't sort of go bad, so to speak. I mean, the ingredients might go bad, but if they do, it's not going to, you know, ruin the smell of your car, for example. The intention and the setting of the spell is done once you have sealed the jar. So I'm going to show you a basic spell jar for protection, and we're going to look at the ingredients that you might use. For this spell jar, I would recommend for each side of the protection, whether you want a back off, I'm going to attack you if you come near me protection spell jar, or if you want a let me keep you safe and nurture you spell jar, the three ingredients that you will have as your base layer are as follows. Of course, it's going to be salt. Some people like to use black salt, some people like to use pink salt. I am going to use pink because I like the colour. But also, it's got a lovely rose essence to it almost, and this is involved with the safety and protection aspect. Salt has been used for centuries. It preserves, it nurtures, and it protects. And this has been used not just in food, for example, curing meats with salt, but also by almost every religion. There's always some form of salt used in their ceremonies, because the magical energy of salt is such that it is one of the strongest ingredients that a witch has in their cupboard. Second up, we're going to look at pepper. Now, pepper is a protective spice. It comes from the pepper tree, and pepper in its white, black, or red or green form is just a varying stages of the unripe pepper as it goes through its ripening process. And the energy that it gets therefore comes from the fruition of the fruit. So the stronger the pepper energy, the stronger the colour you want. And so black peppercorns are the ripest of those, and that is what I'm going to use. Pepper's correspondences are to do with banishing negativity and protection, but it's protection in a I'll strike first kind of way. The more pepper you add to your spell jar, the more of a sting in its tail it will have for those who maybe are looking at coming at you. The third of your base ingredients for your spell jar is the spice cloves. Again, cloves are a natural preservative, antibiotic, and have that preserving, safety, protective nature to them. The cloves were said to represent a nail, especially the nails which were put through Christ's hands in Christian tradition, and the clove sprung from it. So they said. I mean, this is obviously a load of rubbish, because cloves were around long before Christ's child was. The cross formation of a clove is a very powerful protective symbol. The cross is a very strong, powerful sigil for protection, and the clove has it in abundance. So firstly, you will need a small jar with preferably a cork lid, but any small jar will do. and we're going to add the first of our base layers, and in this case, it's going to be pepper. The next addition is going to be my salt, and I'm using Himalayan pink salt for its nurturing and protective qualities. The final layer of the three base ingredients is the cloves. As this spell jar is going to be my sting in the tail protective spell jar, I'm going to add some lavender. Lavender does have a little bit of a spikiness to its energy, as well as love and security. And my final ingredient is lemon peel. Lemons are a great thing to add to any protective jar. They again are this stinging kind of protective, so they're very much keep away, warning, because they've got that citric acidy buzz going on. And people used to use dried lemon peel around their doorsteps just to prevent anything negative entering their homes. So a little bit of lemon peel in your spell jar will add some more Back Off Witch type. And if you haven't seen Back Off Witch, I'll put it up here. Back Off Witch is very good and most enjoyable. It's one of my personal favourites of my videos. My second protective spell jar is going to have again the same base ingredients of salt, pepper and cloves. However, my next ingredient is going to be some fennel flowers. But fennel seed will work just as well. Fennel provides a strong safety and nurturing aspect to this spell jar. And lastly, I'm going to add some lavender flowers, again for the safety and nurturing side, rather than the stingy protectiveness of it. Now is time to add the wax, and I'm just using an old candle stub for this. This is where I'm going to set my intention on the spell jar, pushing my energy into it to create the spell that I want. And here is the final product, ready for you to use. Don't forget to check me out on patreon.com/Ginnymetheral for little events that I'm putting up there over the next couple of weeks. And if you want to contact me, my deets are all down below in the description. In the meantime, I hope you enjoyed this video. Don't forget to like and subscribe, and I will see you next week.